Bin packing is a difficult combinatorial problem. Essentially, you have a number of boxes that you need to fit inside a number of containers. Some examples in everyday life are storing items efficiently in a fridge or packing your bags efficiently for a trip. Industrially, it shows up in a lot of different areas, such as logistics, processor utilization, material cutting, and telecom, to name a few. These boxes and containers are more commonly called weights and bins. One variant of the bin packing problem is if you have a number of variable-sized weights and a number of variable-sized bins, and you need to find some solution that actually packs all of the weights without overflow. The difficulty with bin packing is that the number of ways to pack the bins quickly explodes with the number of items. So to check that a solution is optimal, or to even find a solution at all, quickly becomes impossible. For example, with 9 weights and 9 bins, you get about 400 million permutations. To solve this issue, there are many different algorithms that can be used. One such is the first fit algorithm, which takes the next weight and packs it in the next available bin. Best fit assigns the weight to the smallest bin that it fits in. So if you're packing several travel bags, you would start with the smallest one and completely fill it. Worst fit instead does the opposite and assigns weights to the bins with the most capacity. This may sound like a bad idea, but sometimes it can be effective. The algorithm tends to balance weight distributions, so that it leaves a little bit of room in all of the bins. So this would mean packing your bags evenly, instead of filling them up one by one. For all of these algorithms, you can also first sort the weights in decreasing order, which can often be beneficial. This would mean starting with the biggest items and packing them in your bags first, and then go on with smaller and smaller items. Now these algorithms aren't perfect, and there are several cases where they might fail, so I wanted to see if I could beat them with a more novel approach. So my line of thinking was to make an agent, with a neural network making the decisions, and train that neural network with reinforcement learning. The neural network outputs a bin and weight ID, and feedbacks that to the agent by allocating the chosen weight. This repeats until the entire setup is cleared, or until the agent is unable to make another move. For this agent to learn, we need to define an environment for it to explore, which is going to be a large amount of weights and bins. In order to generate these, I wrote a routine that simply randomizes the weights and bins, and checks how many permutations are valid solutions. This algorithm also allows me to choose a difficulty level, so I can estimate how hard the current setup is to allocate. For the data generation to be efficient, I wrote this algorithm in C++. However, I still restricted myself to moderately small setups because the number of solutions quickly explodes with the number of bins and weights, making it impossible to check that you even can allocate all of the weights. The resulting neural network ended up being only 20 kilobytes in size, in full 64-bit precision. To put this in perspective, that's about the size of a small email without attachments, a small PNG website icon, or about a fifth of the Doom 1993 source code. Even though the neural network is so tiny, it beats all of the algorithms that I talked about, and oftentimes it can actually find solutions where none of the algorithms are able to. For example, here's a setup with over 4 million permutations, and only 4 of them are valid solutions. So in a sense, the neural network finds a 1 in a million solution. To test the neural network more rigorously, I made a dataset of 1,000 challenging sets of weights and bins, and compared it with the classic bin packing algorithms. The neural network packed over 94% of these sets of weights and bins, whereas the best classic algorithm only packed 83%, and it even outperformed all of the algorithms combined. So even if you were to somehow use the best algorithm for each data point, it would still not be as good as the agent. In an even more challenging dataset, the neural network packed about 88%, whereas the best algorithm packed about 69%. It even seems to be able to generalize very nicely to much larger sets than it was trained on. So there are clearly benefits to using this neural network agent compared with classical algorithms. So what's next for this bin packing agent? Well, a nice next step would be to actually generalize the agent to 2D or even 3D bin packing scenarios. This is obviously much more complex. The 1D version actually has a lot of use cases, but a generalized agent for higher dimensions could be a really powerful tool for a multitude of industries. And now I'll just leave you with some examples of the agent in action.